Well, here we are in part two. So first off, fill in some holes. I'm going to delete the tone controls and the pickup switching, so those holes are going to get filled. Super glue front and back just to make sure they don't move. Now I've got to bevel the holes out so I get a smooth transition on the filler, so I don't have a hard edge because it'll crack. So round and round. Standard cheapo automotive body filler, not too cheap, but always mix this stuff on a bit of steel, not cardboard or timber, because it bleaches some of the chemical out of the hardener. It doesn't mix right. So anyway, got to get right down inside this to prepare, because I'm going to also delete the stop power tailpiece, put in a trapeze. Okay, while this stuff's still green and leathery, top's come off with the razor blade, razor knife, which saves a heap of sanding. Once that's done, bring some 180 dry rub just to get it all nice and flat. I've got a flexible rubber block I use for this. Really cheap, must have. That's done over the whole body with 180 flatten roll out, and then grain filler. This is ebony grain filler, so it'll give me a little black specks through the timber. With this stuff too, a little bit goes a long way. There's about a teaspoonful to do the whole back and the sides. Brushing across the grain, try and get down inside those pores. Same thing here, across the grain, and then while it's still wet, paper towel, little circles, just try and work it down in. Stuff dries really fast too, ready to sand in about 45 minutes, an hour maybe. Okay, so back over it again with 180, and then ready to seal coat. So just quick clean, get rid of the dust. And this couple of coats isn't straight clear, it's got some tint that I mixed up out of fingernail polish, believe it or not, just to give me a little bit of a sort of a honey colour. Okay, for the front and the neck, just straight clear, just to seal the timber. Need something to sand. Once that's done, this is the important bit. Make sure that the neck is in the right place in relation to the bridge, because the bridge hole's already drilled. And that it's on center. So first off, just making sure that the neck is in the right place to give me the correct scale length, which it wasn't. And I've cut out a lot of the filing that went on here. Okay, now to get it on the center line, which again, it isn't. So although the neck is too loose in the neck slot, I've still got to take a little bit off so I can pull it up square and line it up with the center line. I'll take care of that when I actually bolt the neck in and shim it. And at the same time take care of the brake angle on the neck so I'm the right height for the bridge. So everything's lining up nice, and I'll just mark the hole for the neck bolts. And also for the trapeze. So that's about it for now. Catch you next time.